بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. Upon reading this beneficial book of Sheikh of Imam Ahmed رحمه تبارك وتعالى, which is called أصول السنة, with the explanation of Sheikh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, may Allah سبحانه وتعالى grant him success in this life and the hereafter. And we have reached الجهاد ماض إلى يوم القيامة مع البر والفاجر. And he mentioned والعزو والغزوة ماض مع الأمراء إلى يوم القيامة البر والفاجر لا يترك. And this is what we had covered, barakallahu fikum, for the past 4 or 5 weeks, which was in regard to the military expeditions they are to be carried out, and with the Imam إلى يوم القيامة. Let it be, he is a righteous Imam, meaning a leader, with the leader. Let it be a righteous leader or a wicked leader. So therefore, at any case, as long as he's the leader, then the military expedition is not to be abandoned. So بإذن الله تعالى, what we're going to be dealing with, and I hope we're covering those issues of al-jihad. Alhamdulillah, we understood properly what is al-jihad. And we also understand, barakallahu fikum, that these individuals, the likes of the ISIS, the likes of the Daesh, the likes of the Boko Haram, the likes of the Ansaruddin, that all of them, what they claim as jihad, it is not jihad at all. It is fawda. It is yani bringing humiliation to the Muslims. It is yani being in opposition with the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it is in opposition with the madhab of Ahlu Sunnati wal Jama'a as-Salaf as-Salih. And alhamdulillah, for us yani going through this from the works of Sheikh Fawzan, that allow us barakallahu fikum to understand properly. So nobody will yani come and steal our aqeedah from us, the aqeedah that is correct. And nobody will come and yani play with our religion, or nobody will come and play with the religion of our children. But rather, alhamdulillah, knowing this, we know that if this Daesh, this ISIS, this Al-Qaeda, and all of these deviant sects from the Khawarij, then we will know right away that what they upon is falsehood. It is upon batil. It is not upon what the Salaf al-Salih they used to be upon. So therefore, we are, alhamdulillah, well equipped with yani refuting them and being ready, alhamdulillah, not to be yani taking any of their foolishness, alhamdulillah. So today, tonight, the night of the 27th night of Muharram, the night of the 27th night, if I'm not mistaken, of Muharram, that we are reading Walqisma al-Fay wa Iqamatul Hudud ila أئمة الماضي ليس لأحد أن يطعن عليهم ولا ينازعهم ودفع الصدقات إليهم جائزة نافضة من دفعها إليهم أجرت عنه برا كان أو فاجرا. Imam Ahmed رحمه الله say, and this is what we're going to be dealing with tonight inshallah, it is in regard to the division of the spoils of war. In regard to the division of the spoils of war, he mentioned, Imam Ahmed, he say that the division of the spoils of war, it is likewise from the responsibility of the Muslim ruler. It is from the responsibility of the Muslim ruler. It is from the responsibility of the Muslim ruler. And he say that establishing or dividing the spoils of war, and likewise establishing the legal punishment, and likewise these two things that he mentioned, along with the the call for the jihad and the like, they say it is the responsibility of the Imam. He say ليس لأحد أن يطعن عليهم. He say it is for no one to be slandering the imam, meaning the leader. It is for no one to be slandering the Muslim leader. And he say wala yunazi'uhum, and it is for nobody to be contesting their leadership. Nobody to be contesting their leadership. He say wa daf'u sadaqati ilayhim ja'izatun nafidhatun. He say that giving them the zakat, meaning the Muslim leader, giving them the zakat, it is permissible, and if one has done it, he has executed his zakat. It is as if he has yani pay of his zakat. He say man dafa'aha ilayhim. He say whoever will give it to them, meaning give them the zakat, it will be sufficient for him. Now let it be the imam barran kana aw fajiran. Let him be the most righteous one or the most despicable wicked one. It doesn't matter where he will fit in this interval. Let it be the most righteous one or he be the worst of the Muslim, but he is the leader. طيب. So giving him the zakat and barakallahu fikum, giving him the zakat and him distributing the spoils of war and establishing the legal punishment and establishing the legal punishment, that this is barakallahu fikum his responsibility. Let him be to be even guilty of that which he is establishing the legal punishment. Right? Now that he might be a fornicator, wal'ayadhu billah. And if he established the had on a fornicator, then that does what? It take place. And wala yunazi'uhum. And nobody will be barakallahu fikum contesting their leadership. وَلَا يُطْعَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ, and nobody is to be slandering them. As we mentioned from the statement of Sheikh Fawzan, that al-khuruj al-hukam, that revolting against the ruler, it is of three types. Imma the individual do it by way of, don't sit on my right. Yes, by way of his speech, or by way of his, yes, by way of his hands. And the first one, and by way of his heart. He hate the ruler in his heart. He doesn't say anything, but he hate the guts of the ruler. He hate his guts. He doesn't want to. He hate him. If he wish to go against him, he will go against him. Well, if he got the power to go against him, he will go against him. The second thing is that the individual yut'an alayhim, he speak bad about them. He speak bad about the leader. طيب. And the other one is the one that actually goes out and yani raise the sword against the Muslim ruler. All of this, barakallahu fik, it is not permissible yani for the Salafi, for the Muslim, for the Sunni to be doing these actions in regard to the Muslim ruler. So Sheikh Rabi ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, may Allah give him good in this life, in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him as-sadat. Ameen. He mentioned, Allahumma atala umruhu ala al-khayr. May Allah give him a long life upon good. Ameen. He mentioned, he say, وَقِسْمَةُ الْفَيْءِ وَإِقَامَةِ الْحُدُودِ إِلَىٰ أَئِمَّةِ الْمَاضِي لَيْسَ لِأَحَدٍ أَنْ يُطْعَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا يُنَازِعُهُمْ. He say, فَيَرَى Imam Ahmed, Sharabi, he say, Imam Ahmed رحمه الله, he sees that أن قسمة الفي للأمراء, that distributing the spoils of war, it is the responsibility of the ruler. It is the responsibility of the ruler. And he say, likewise, وَيَرَى أَنَّ إِقَامَةُ الْحُدُودِ فِي الزِّنَا وَالْقَتْلِ وَالسَّرِقِ وَالشُّرُبُ الْخَمْرِ وَمَا شَاكَلَ ذَلِكَ. He say, إِلَى الْحُكَّامِ لَيْسَ لِلْأَفْرَادِ وَلَا لِلْطَوَائِفِ وَلَا لِلْطَوَائِفِ. And he say that he sees also Imam Ahmed rahimahullah from the foundation of Islam. From the foundation of Islam, it is that the establishment of the division of the spoils of war, it is the responsibility of the Muslim ruler. As we see that barakallahu fikum, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the one that used to do what? That divide the spoils of war. He was the one that distributed. And the amount he will give you might be different from the amount he will give the other one. And we will come to, inshallah ta'ala, see how the backbone, or where it really Khawarij started it. And as Shaykh Uthaymeen mentioned in the explanation of the, this tremendous book that is called Aqidatul Wasatiyya, he said that the origin of all these deviant sects is the Khawarij. The origin of all the first deviant sect that came was al Khawarij. So he mentioned here, so likewise Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he sees, and this is the madhab of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Because remember Imam Ahmad, he is the one that had the title of what? Imam Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Tayyib. He said, وَيَرَى أَنَّ إِقَامَةِ الْحُدُودِ. He said that he also has the belief system, and this is the belief system of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that establishing the legal punishment for the fornicator or for the adulterer, wal qatl, and for the one that yani, for the murderer, and likewise the one that is the robber or the somebody the thief, and likewise the one that is yani, using intoxicants, wa sharb al khamr, طيب, the one that is using intoxicants. He say wa ma ashkala dhalika, and the likes of all of these crimes, it is the responsibility of the ruler. It is the responsibility of the al-hukam, the ruler. He say, "Laysa lil-afrad." It is not for yani individuals. Wala lil-tawaif, and it is not for groups. It is not for individual to do this, or it is not for a group to be doing this. It is not for a group to be doing this, nor for ifrad, meaning an individual on his own, or for a group, or a masjid, or a region to be doing this on their own. As you find in the West End, they used to have this. They used to have their own Iqamatul Hudud. Right? They will give you a bulletproof vest, and they will shoot you on it. Seriously. They used to do this. And هذا يدل على جهل هؤلاء. That this shows the ignoramism of this individual. Akhi, this is why, wallahi, we need the ulama. We need the ulama, maybe more than we need food and drink. Because without the ulama, كيف نفهم النصوص? How would we understand the text? How? Now a person might read this and think that, well, the leader, he's the imam of the masjid. Or he's the, what you call it, the guy, the brother that is cleaning the bathroom in the masjid, which is very noble, alhamdulillah. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found out about this lady that died, and the Sahaba ridwanullah alayhi ajma'in, they buried her. But the Messenger did not know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not happy. And this shows the status that the Prophet had for the one that was cleaning the masjid. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and did what? Made the janazah, barakallahu fiqh, on her gravesite. So this shows what? The importance of what? That the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave to those who used to be having this wadifa, this responsibility of cleaning the masjid. So therefore, alhamdulillah, we should not undermine these things that, alhamdulillah, will come very handy yawm al-qiyamah. Right? And not to say that this is not my responsibility or somebody else going to do it, but rather it is all of our responsibility, inshallah. This was a side note. So he mentioned that this is not for the afraad. This is not for like individuals or a tawa'if group. وَإِنَّمَا يَتَوَلَّى الْأَمْرِ فِي ذَلِكَ الْحَاكِمِ. But rather the responsibility fall under who? In the hands of the leader, the Muslim leader. To start to divide the spoils of war. To barakallahu fikum, yani to the spoils of war. To establish the hudud, the legal punishment.